So every muscle has many muscle cells, and every muscle cell is filled with myofibrils. Myofibrils are all of these individual rod-like structures. And each myofibril is made of many sarcomeres. So the myofibril is like the train, the sarcomere is like an individual train car. So all of those sarcomeres lined up end to end make the myofibril. The sarcomere is the contractile unit of both cardiac and skeletal muscle. So you only see these in cardiac and skeletal, not smooth. Sarcomeres are separated by Z discs, so the space in between two individual Z discs is the sarcomere. And the middle of the sarcomere has something called an M line. It's just the midline anchor point of the sarcomere. So remember, you have two contractile proteins, actin and myosin. The myosin is the thick filament, and it is anchored to the Z disc by an elastic filament that is sometimes also called titin. That titin is anchoring the myosin to the Z disc, but also the core of the myosin is actually made of titin, so it's also anchoring the myosin to the M line. So myosin are the thick filaments, and actin are the thin filaments, and those are just anchored to the Z disc. So this patterning here is what ultimately causes both cardiac and skeletal muscle to have striations, those light and dark bands. In the middle, where it is only thick filament, we call that the H zone. And the H zone is part of a larger band called the A band. So the A band is where it's only thick filaments, or where the thick and thin filaments are overlapping. So the A band contains the H zone. The I band is where there's only thin filaments, so where there's only those actin filaments. And this patterning, I remember it as high. H A I, high. And this gives us our light and dark bands. So the A band is going to be darker than the I band because it has the sections that are overlapping and the section with the thicker filaments. But within the A band, there is a slightly lighter band, which is the H zone, because there's only thick filaments, there's no overlapping. It's just a little bit lighter than the outer edges of the A where there is overlapping. And then that M line in the middle makes the very center a little bit darker. So now I want you to think, when the myosin grabs onto the actin, it's going to pull the actin towards the M line. So when that happens, what's going to happen to the size of each of these bands or zones? So that was our relaxed sarcomere. Now we're looking at the contracted. You can see that the entire sarcomere has gotten smaller when the actin moved towards the midline. So that titin filament kind of coils up. The actin moves towards the midline, and it all gets a little bit smaller. But which of the bands have gotten smaller to cause the whole sarcomere to become smaller. So the H zone has completely disappeared, because remember, the H zone was where it was only thick filaments with no overlapping thin. Now that the actin is towards the midline, our H zone is gone. The I band, remember, that's where there's only thin filaments. That has gotten smaller because there are more sections where thick and thin are overlapping. The A band, well, technically it's not actually gotten larger because it's restricted to the length of the myosin. The myosin hasn't gotten longer. However, proportionally compared to the size of the whole sarcomere, it is now proportionally larger. Originally, you know, maybe we'd say it was 30%. Now it's closer to 80% of the total length of the sarcomere. So the way I think of this in my head is that we go from high to I, and you can see I've drawn the A bigger because it's proportionally larger and the I smaller.